we reflect the Romans 11:29. The call and gift of God are irrevocable. The one who called us continues to remain faithful. He continues to walk with us. When we go away from Him, when we fall in our failures, when we are dying in our weakness, He just waits. It's very difficult to understand the heart of the Spirit unless we move with the Spirit. Yes, a man of the Spirit, Samson, lying in the filth of sin. He is lying at the feet of a prostitute, drunk. And he sees suddenly thousands of enemies, Philistines, are before him with the swords and spears. He sees, he hears the so-called lady who is supposed to give him pleasure. She is the traitor. She has taken the money and brought these thousands of people. This is the world. In the name of love, the enemy takes you to the lust. In the name of pleasure, the enemy takes you to tie up. You tie you up with the world, tie you up with sin, tie you up with the darkness. We read in the beautiful Psalm 25, verse 15, when my eyes are upon you, when my eyes are upon you, when I look towards you, yes, you untie all the bondages of my feet. Yes, many are the bondages he tries to. He binds me with the sin. He binds me with all kinds of relationship. He binds me with all kinds of sickness. He tries to do all that he has. But when I look upon him, I always rejoice and celebrate the beautiful prayer, the prayer of the King Jehoshaphat. King Jehoshaphat prayed in his moment of need, Lord, the enemy before me are too many. The army that is fighting against me is too many. Second, I don't know what to do. My mind has become blind. It has become just blackout. I don't know what to do. But third thing he said, but my eyes are upon you. But my eyes are upon you. The enemies are too many. I don't know what to do. But amidst all this, I know one thing. My eyes are upon you. And God did bring glory and victory to him. Do you know the enemy is preparing a band of people to work against the kingdom? And the so-called the chosen children of God, they are busy in their own little world. They live their life. They want to make them happy themselves. That is the trick of the enemy, attack of the enemy, to make them zero. They do not know. The so-called children of God, Christian community, they are become cowards. They are become frightened people. They are being constantly attacked by the enemy. And the people do not know it is the attack of the enemy. And people do not know they are on the war. They are fired. Because when the Holy Spirit comes, he comes with glory and power. But when he goes away from, we read in the book of Judges chapter 16 verse 20. When the Holy Spirit went away from Samson, he did not know that the Spirit has left him. Yes, the Spirit left him. Yes. Where is the evil spirit? He will not, you will not know how does he come inside you. But when you say go away, he will not go. He will show his color. He will throw you into the fire. He will bring something out of your mouth. He will make you falling. Yes, different way he will. Suddenly he will make you to hit at your wife. For what? Hit at your TV, which you hardly earn, with hard work you have earned. You will abuse your own father. Why? You are fired. You do not know. Now we will understand what is the Spirit, Holy Spirit does. Number one, He protects His children who are attacked by the fear, who are not willing to stand for Him with the cowardice. They try to keep themselves back. No, not me. We read in the book of 1 Kings chapter 18, the servant of God Elijah is faced with a situation where 420 prophets are standing against him. The Lord says, you and your God together is a majority. You and your God, if joined together, you are the majority always. Because God is who made heaven and the earth. Let any amount of people come, they are only belong to the earth. But your God belongs to God, earth and heaven. So man can fight from down only. At the most, the enemy can fight from the akasham, sky. But God will fight from heaven. So, the Holy Spirit comes to protect His children who are attacked by the spirit of covetousness, who are attacked by timidity, who are attacked by fright, fear, and tie them up with the fear. Yes, when Elijah has to fight against 420 people, he looked upon the Lord. He began to fast and said, Lord, I'm going to the place where the challenge is going to take place, where they challenged that I will kill a bull, you also kill a bull. We have to put in both of our altars and we have to pray. I will pray to my God, you pray to your God. First you pray to your God. If your God is the real God, let the fire come from your God. You should not put the fire. I will not put the fire. I will pray to my God and my God will give the fire. Challenge is over. The whole town has come already to that place. I have seen that place when I went to Jerusalem. I climbed. It is not able to climb. It's the Carmel mountain. It's a beautiful mountain where they kept the statue of Elijah, where he challenged the black magicians, the soothsayers, the Baal prophets. They said, easy, we'll just make a small prayer. Our evil spirit that is in the sky, he will give us the power, we will bring fire. It's not a big thing. They did not prepare. They just came. But Elijah went the previous night. He climbed on the mountain. He was fasting and praying. And he covered the place with the presence of God. If you fill yourself with the spirit of God, the evil spirit will not go inside you. The tragedy of God's servants and the children of God is, they don't fill themselves. They don't get up themselves and fill themselves every minute with the presence of God. So, the presence of evil easily peeps, gets into the life of God's children, gets into the mind of God's children. And when they are attacked, they look towards God. God says, move from inside to out. Be filled with my presence. And you move. 1 Corinthians 10:31. Every minute, praise God. Thank God. Be conscious of the Spirit of God in you. And move with Him. Celebrate Him. But man tries to come from out to in. He is namesake. He is the child of God. He allows the family problem. He allows that what's happening in the nation. He allows what's happening, the disturbance. Everything becomes part of his life. He allows everything to hold him. And everything is pulling him. And that moment, he tries to come inside. With the darkness, he is trying to reach light. Rather, God asks us, possess my light and overcome the darkness. Your life, your call of a Christian is constantly train your mind to be in the presence. constantly empower yourself with the spirit and understand the works of the enemy and conquer the enemy. Our life is from inside to out. The lotus that is inside, it comes out. Yes. It is not from outside to in. You can't allow yourself to be drowned in the outside world. You become victim. You become broken. Lord, my family has become like this. That is what the man from outside to in. I'm being attacked by this. You become a helpless man. You become a beggar. Your prayer life becomes a begging life. Lord, please help me. If you don't, what will happen to me? Whereas if you move from within, you are filled with the presence. You know for truth that your God is a living God. He is a loving Father. He is a mighty God. He is God Almighty. And He is a God of wisdom, all-knowing. Sarvajnani, Sarvandaryami, Sarvashaktudu. So these three things are, every minute haunts your mind. Your God is a loving Father. Your God is Almighty. Your God is a God of wisdom who is present everywhere.